But this was Marcus Grönholm's rally. He led virtually from start to finish. A stylish way to win his first World Championship rally, and a stylish way to give Peugeot their first win since 1986. I'm walking through.
Did you hear that Tommy had gone off during the rally?
Yes, I heard that, but that is very sad, because that is always sad.
Out in front though, on his own from stage 11 of the Swedish rally, Sebastian Loeb.
His rivals must be thinking, this year's championship's going in one direction. And that's Loeb's. His first win on gravel is not far away, but making history here has shown that he's outclassed the best drivers that Europe has produced over the years. He's not only fast, but makes no mistakes. That's a winning combination.
So it's a victory for France and Sweden. Sebastian Loeb is the star of the North.
To be the first non-Scandinavian to win is very nice, because it proves that there are not only the Scandinavians who can go fast in this kind of roads.
Congratulations, Sebastian. A great, great victory for you.
Thank you. I'm very, very happy to win here, because in Sweden, it's more than we could expect before, so very happy.
Solberg's targeted 2 wins for 2005, and this one will be special in front of his Scandinavian supporters. And yes, that's it. The Norwegian is the champion of Sweden.
Okay, we lost the last stage today.
Yes! It's the first win for Subaru and Pirelli in Sweden since 1997.
Good job. Really good.
It's been a good weekend.
And for Solberg, it's a new surface mastered, his first victory on snow.
It's incredible, incredible. It's been a dream for me, big dream, you know. It's all the fans who supported from Norway, Sweden, everywhere, just come here and look at everything what they have done, and it's just incredible.
I haven't done one single mistake the whole rally. Things have been just perfect, and the team have been just incredible, because they have put everything up to the next level about you know, small details, and that is very, very important. So, all the fans and supporters, and it's just incredible.
Back with Latvala now, though, who's on course to become the youngest ever driver to win a world rally. The previous holder of that record was fellow Finn Harry Toivonen, who won the 1980 World GB couple of months shy of his 23rd birthday. Lavela is on course to beat that record by 2 years. It's a clear first WRC victory for Yanni Matti Lavela and Mikko Antola. And understandably, it's an emotional moment for the young Finnish crew.
Yanni Matti, this day will stay with you for the rest of your life. You're the youngest ever winner of a World Rally.
The guy who was before me was Henri Toivonen, and he was 24 years old, and he is a big idol of me. And in my secret mind, I have been thinking that I want to beat this record, and actually we did it, and we did it here in Sweden. It's unbelievable feeling, such a difficult Monte Carlo start, and you know, it's amazing how good feeling it was driving this rally.
Mikko Hirvonen, the first to congratulate Yanni Matti. And he is quickly followed by Yanni Matti's dad. Memorable scenes at the end of this stage. Matti's achievement means he was the unanimous winner of the Abu Dhabi Spirit of the Rally Award. His team boss, Malcolm Wilson, handing over the trophy. Looks like he's discovered another fast thing.
I was very confident to win a rally during the season, but I really expected it to be the latter half. But, you know, he led from the start. Okay, the pressure was eased somewhat once Sebastian went and Mikko eased off the pressure. But to have the pressure of, you know, leading for 3 days, the fact of being the youngest driver ever to possibly win a World Rally, and obviously thinking about the manufacturer points from Ford point of view, then he was under a lot of pressure, and to deliver it in the style and the way that he's done it, it just shows what the future really holds for him.